See that little symbol right there? That little symbol means percent. And percent means per hundred. And that's all you need to know in order to be able to work with percent. Because once you know that, percent means per hundred, you can turn a percent into a decimal. You can turn a percent into a fraction. You know how to work with decimals. You know how to work with fractions. So percent means per hundred, and you're done. Let's check it out. We're going to turn some percents into decimals. Make sure we have that down. Then we're going to work with percents and fractions. Make sure we have that down. Then we're going to move on to some percentage problems. We'll start here, turning 42% into a decimal. Percent means per hundred, so 42% means 42 per 100. Of course, we know how to divide by 100. We move the decimal point two places to the left, and we get 0.42. On to the next one, 337%. That's 337 per 100. Again, dividing by 100, move the decimal point two places to the left, 3.37. Of course, now you start to see we don't really need this middle step. This percent symbol, all it means is divide by 100. Divide by 100, move the decimal point two places to the left. You get 3.37 up here. Move the decimal point two places to the left. You get 0.42. On to the next one, the 1.5%. Don't really need that middle step. Move the decimal point two places to the left. You get 0.015. Got to remember that zero right there because we're moving two to the left. And our last one, 6%. Again, we move the decimal point two places to the left. We get 0.06. Not 0.6. We get 0.06. All right, now that we got this down, turning percents into decimals, we're going to run it back. We're going to turn some decimals into percents. Now, percent means per hundred, so I want to write this 0.37 as something per 100, something over 100. Well, 0.37 is just 37 hundredths, which, of course, is 37%, because percent means per hundred. So once I have 37 per 100, I have 37%. Now, of course, I can turn negatives. Nothing special about negatives. I can turn a negative into a percent as well. Now, I need to write this as something divided by 100. I'm going to write this as 24.3 divided by 100. Once again, you see, dividing by 100, you move decimal point two places to the left. That would give us 0.243. Now, going the other direction here, 24.3 per 100. That's a percent per 100. 24.3%. And now we see what we're doing here. Back here, to turn a percent into a decimal, all we did was take the decimal point and move it two places to the left to get our decimals. Now, to turn a decimal into a percent, we move the decimal point two places to the right. 0.37, move the decimal point two places to the right, we get 37%. 37% to move back to 0.37, we move the decimal point two places to the left. And that's just because of this middle step right here. The percent means per hundred. You got that down? You can easily turn any percent into a decimal and any decimal into a percent. So let's try turning some into fractions. 50%, that's 50 per 100. You got it, that's one half. 62.5%. Once again, the percent just means per hundred. 62.5 over 100. Now, I want to get rid of that decimal, so I'm going to multiply the top and bottom. I'm going to multiply the top and bottom by 10 here. That'll definitely get rid of the decimal. We'll have 625 over 1,000. Now, I could start taking out common factors, but I'm going to go ahead and find the prime factorizations of both these. I'm going to make it a little easier to simplify. 625 is 25 squared. 25 itself is 5 squared. So this 625 is the square of 5 squared. This is 5 to the 4th. 1,000 is 2 cubed times 5 cubed. And now I see how I can simplify this. I can take out 3 factors of 5. Take out 3 factors of 5 from the top and the bottom. I'm left with 5 over 2 cubed, which is 5/8. Now I'm on to 33 and a third. And once again, we start off by writing this as per 100. 33 and a third per 100. Now I'll write the numerator here. That's a mixed number. I'm going to write that as a fraction. 33 times 3 is 99. Plus the 1, that's 1/3 divided by 100. And when you're dividing by 100, that's the same thing as multiplying by the reciprocal, which of course is 1 over 100. The 100s cancel. And we're left with 1/3. Finally, 100%. 100%, yeah, that's an easy one. We're used to 100%, right? 100 over 100, that's 1. 100% is 1. 0% is 0. Those are the easy ones. Now that we know how to turn percents into fractions, let's learn how to turn fractions into percents. Well, let's see. I know how to turn something over 100 into percent, because something over 100, that's something percent. So if I can turn this into something over 100, then I'll be set. So we're going to use that strategically multiplying by 1 strategy. Multiply this by 25 over 25, because that'll make my denominator 100. And once I've got 25 per 100, then I know I've got 25%. This one's harder, because I can't easily multiply 8 by some integer to get 100 to do what I did up here, but I do know how to turn this into a decimal. And I know how to turn a decimal into a percent, so I'm going to turn this into a decimal first. I turn this into a decimal by making the denominator a power of 10, where I could divide the 8 into the 9. Well, to make the denominator a power of 10, first I'll look at the 8 as 2 cubed. And that tells me I need to multiply the top and bottom by 5 cubed. So that'll give me on the top, 9 times 5 cubed is 125. And on the bottom I have 2 cubed times 5 cubed, that's the cube of 2 times 5. That's 10 cubed. And I multiply 9 and 125, I'll multiply 9 and 100, it'll give me 900. 9 times 25 will give me 225. I add those up, I get 1125. Over 1,000. I know how to turn that into a decimal. I just take my 1125, move the decimal point over 3 places, because I'm dividing by 3 factors of 10 here. I get 1.125. Finally, we know how to turn this into a percent. We move that decimal point 2 places over, and we get 112.5%. And now that we've mastered turning fractions and decimals into percents, and turning percents into fractions and decimals, we're ready to move on to some percentage problems.